So welcome to Bhakti Sagar Japa conference call. Today we are very fortunate to have His Grace Ram Gadhari Prabhu to enlighten us on Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. So Prabhuji, are you present on the call?
Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, please accept my humble obeisances. All goodies to Srila Prabhupada, all goodies to Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much Prabhuji for giving your valuable association and time. So now I would like to hand over the call to you, Prabhuji. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
हरि बोल। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद। Reading from Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, Chapter 24, Text Number 220. Ye charyartha saha haila teisha artha arafina artha shuna paramas samartha. Translation and purport by Isvan Vethethi Bhaktivedana Samishla Prabhupada, Shla Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. In addition to the 19 meanings of the verse mentioned previously, there are 4 further meanings when the word Atma Rama is taken to mean those laboring under the bodily conception. This brings the total to 23. Now hereof another 3 meanings which are very suitable. Purport. The 3 further meanings of the words are understood when the word cha is taken to mean in due course. The word cha is taken to mean eva, and the word api means censure, and the word nirgrantha is taken to mean one who is very poor without money. Text 221. Chashabde samujaya ara artakaya atma ramascha munayascha krishne rabajaya. As mentioned above, the word cha can be used to mean aggregate. According to this meaning, all the atma ramas and munis engage in Krishna's service. Besides aggregate, there is another meaning of the word cha. Text 222. Nirgrantahana ihanapi nirdharane ramascha krishnascha yata viharayevane. The word nirgrantaha can be used as an adjective, and api can be used in the sense of certainty. For instance, ramascha krishnascha means both Rama and Krishna enjoy walking in the forest. Purport. Because it is said that both Rama and Krishna enjoy wandering in the forest, it is understood that both of them are enjoying their tour within the forest. Text 223. Chashabde anvachaye artakahe ara bato bhiksham atagam chanaya yeche prakara. The word cha can also present a secondary thing to be done at the same time. This way of understanding the word cha is called anvachaye. An example is, O brahmachari, go out to collect alms and at the same time bring in the cows. Text 224. Krishna manane muni krishna sarvada bhajaya atma rama api bhaje gauna artakaya. Translation. saintly persons who are always meditating upon Krishna are engaged in the devotional service of the Lord. The Atma Ramas are also engaged in the Lord's service. That is the indirect import, purport. The Anavachaya meaning of the word cha indicates that between two words compounded by the word cha, one is given more importance and the other is considered subordinate. For example, O Brahmachari, please go out and collect alms and at the same time bring in the cows. In this statement, the collection of the alms is of first importance. The second business of collecting the cows is subordinate. Similarly, one who always meditates upon Krishna is mainly a devotee of Krishna engaged in his devotional service. Other Atma Ramas are subordinate in devotional service. We will discuss till 224. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Sadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we are in the context where Mahaprabhu is explaining the Atma Ramas Chamunaya verse. So Mahaprabhu is very analytically and detailedly explaining the meaning, breaking the meanings into different perspectives. And Mahaprabhu, when he explain about Atma, he is referring Atma as body. He is referring how one in bodily conception worship his own body as Brahman, which means the ultimate beneficiary. He is also explaining how those people who are considering Atma as the body, they give importance to, you know, various yogic gymnastic processes and slowly elevate their whatever the kundalini or chakra or whatever you may call. And some of them who are engaged in the fruitive activities because of the bodily conception, they also consider Atma and body, Atma as body. So like that, Mahaprabhu is going on explaining, and finally he is concluding the six different explanations of how Atma, from a bodily perspective, as devotees, we respect, we worship, we glorify Atma beyond this materialistic context. How Atma is Satchidananda Vigraha. I mean, how Atma is Satchidananda. Now Mahaprabhu, from verse number 220, he is explaining four more meanings to add it to the list, where he is trying to consolidate the thoughts by putting in a statement saying Atma Rama means those laboring under the bodily conception. And he is explaining, the Atmaramas also engage in Krishna's service by explaining the word cha. And Srila Prabhupada is giving a easy explanation for us to understand this particular context. What are the four different explanations of Atma Rama? Where one is in due course, and second is one who is poor without money, and third, Srila Prabhupada writes that word cha is taken to mean eva and the word api to mean censure. We need to understand the Krishna consciousness perspective that has been brought by Mahaprabhu in this whole chapter, and specifically the reason that he has chosen to so analytically explain this verse. In the fag end of this chapter, when Sanatana Goswami is submitting himself to Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu says that this is one verse that I have analytically explained to you, my dear friend. If one becomes mad after Srimad Bhagavatam, then every statement, every verse of Srimad Bhagavatam need to be scrutinizingly studied. And eventually establish Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. So we are going to discuss some sets of reflections for these five verses that we read today. And the first reflection is from this context of analyzing the shloka in such a detailed manner. Srila Prabhupada is encouraging all his students that each and every one of them should be independently thoughtful. When explained about this independently thoughtful nature, Srila Prabhupada did not want us to be some sentimentalists. He did not want us to be who get misguided . And Srila Prabhupada says this Krishna consciousness movement is meant for training men to be independently thoughtful and competent in all types of knowledge action. How is this independently thoughtful conversation is relevant to this context? I will read a portion of a lecture by Srila Prabhupada on Brahma Samhita. He gave this lecture in Los Angeles on August 14, 1972. it's slightly, you know, we are going deeper to this context. I will bring it back to the current situation. First, I'll read what Srila Prabhupada spoke. Quote unquote. Realization means you should write, every one of you, what is your realizations? What for this back to God it is? You write your realization. What you have realized about Krishna. That is required. It is not passive. Always you should be active. Whenever you find time, you write. Never mind 2 lines, 4 lines, but you write your realization. Shravanam is dhanam, writing or offering prayers, glories. This is one of the functions of the Vaishnava. You are hearing, but you have to write also. Now I will join the connectivity over here. Mahaprabhu is explaining this verse in such a detailed manner, and after finishing is this 64 different explanation of Atma Ramasya Munayaha. Mahaprabhu is directing Sanatana Goswami to give detailed explanation and churn Srimad Bhagavatam further. So Sanatana Goswami is compiling Brihad Bhagavata Amrita also from the perspective of the inspiration that he derived from this conversation. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining about bodily conception, Atma Rama means one who is laboring under bodily conception. It means that eventually in due course of time they will also come to Krishna. It also means that Srila Prabhupada gives the word censure, which means disapproving. Or a person who is having a severe disapproval of something or someone, which means eventually negate the bodily conceptions altogether because of slowly coming in contact. That's what Mahaprabhu is building up the context, where even though a person is in bodily consciousness, but if he comes in contact with a pure devotee, he will also become pure. So if you now string this verse together, Mahaprabhu is saying from 20, you know, verse number 220 to 223 or 224, the four different meanings are: a person who is laboring in bodily consciousness, but if they are pursuing his process of devotional service by coming in contact with pure devotee, or if they are in touch with spiritual consciousness, or if they are trying to be serious in their devotional endeavor, then in due course of time, for certainty, they will be able to negate the bodily consciousness and eventually get situated in Krishna consciousness. So that is the indirect import. That's the 22-24. The saintly persons who are always meditating upon Krishna are engaged in devotional service to the Lord. The Atma Ramas are also engaged in Lord's service. That is an indirect import. Even though the Atma Ramas are subordinate in devotional service because they are impersonalists, but if they come in contact with the self-realized soul, this process can purify them for certainty. This is a very scientific statement. So the reflection here is, independently thoughtful nature is expected out of a practicing devotee, because he should understand in no context, in no situation, bodily concept of life is ever accepted, and in no state somebody can give some perspectives and establish this bodily consciousness. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's agenda is also to establish how this bhakti movement main focus is to elevate somebody, even though they are apparently involved in spiritual activities, they will eventually elevate him to the level of spiritual consciousness and Krishna consciousness. So he is very analytically explaining this, and similarly there are many, 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 many verses in Srimad Bhagavatam which talks in depth about the process of Krishna consciousness. To consolidate the thoughts of the first reflection, we learn to need to independently be thoughtful. The way Sanatana Goswami and Rupa Goswami, when they received the instruction from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they became independently thoughtful and eventually compiled books after books and literature after literature to glorify Mahaprabhu, just based on the seed that Mahaprabhu gave, just based on the inspiration and the revelation Mahaprabhu gave. They compiled many, many, many books. In fact, Mahaprabhu's direct instruction to Rupa Goswami was that, now I have explained at the end of Rupa Siksha, if you remember, now that I have explained you so much detailed science of Krishna consciousness, you may now detail them. And now, in this particular chapter, he is showing by an example, by taking one verse, of how the detailing can be done and how this detailing needs to be connected to the ultimate target, which is to be Krishna conscious. How we need to pave the way and join the dots together and say how even the person in impersonal platform, how a person even in the Brahman realization, how a person in bodily consciousness, how a person in whatever lower strata of consciousness, if they try to do an endeavor, they can eventually make it to the Supreme Lord, and we need to create an inroads. So the purpose of Vedic literature, the purpose of instructions by Supreme Lord Arjuna was also that what can we do, how one can orient himself to come to the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord. So this independent thoughtful nature is expected of a devotee, so that in his preaching, in his realizations and in his journey in Krishna consciousness, all the revelations that he gets as a part of his maturity as well as a part of his growth in Krishna consciousness, they need to be shared so that the generations to come can take advantage. It's slightly technical and complex. I'm not sure if I did completely clarity on the current scenario. But the message here is that Atma Ramas are subordinates to the main Krishna consciousness people. Because main Krishna consciousness devotees who are meditating upon Supreme Lord, they're anyway directly engaged. Mahaprabhu already gave a detailed explanation of how that happens. He gave example of Vrindavan, Radharani, birds, cuckoo, how they conduct themselves. So many explanations he gave. Now he is explaining the other part of it, how somebody who is subordinate in due course and for certainty will start to disagree that I am this body, even though they began from a bodily conception. Hence, we as students of Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Okay, can you hear me? Hear me, because in between I got some disconnection.
Yeah, we can hear you, Prabhuji.
Yeah, oh sorry. So Mahaprabhu is trying to take us through the journey of Krishna consciousness in a very scientific manner. So the reflection on independent thoughtfulness is something that is expected of us as students of Krishna consciousness. The second reflection is, in the Krishna consciousness journey, when we are philosophically inclined, one is expected of four dimensions. I spoke about this in another forum yesterday, but I will repeat that aspect over here. In the sense that for us to progress in Krishna consciousness, we generally philosophically state that we need to have the right set of desires. We need to have right set of Shraddha, right set of association, and eventually we reach our goal. But then, this is, every one of us understand this, basics of Krishna consciousness and the theory of Krishna consciousness is pretty much clear for each and every one. There is nothing new that we are going to speak. Every time we speak Krishna as Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hare Krishna Mahamantra is the ultimate process, association of devotees, Srimad Bhagavatam, Dham, holy name, all of those things are repeated and there is no contradiction. But then, in the philosophical analysis or philosophical understanding, there are four dimensions that needs to be understood, which is my second reflection. The four dimensions are, number one, philosophical clarity. Number two, scrutinizingly study the philosophy. Number three, application of that philosophy. And number four, being the recipient of Lord's mercy and Vaishnava's mercy. And this particular context, why are we relating it? I'll, you know, join to the context. If you remember, the whole purpose of Mahaprabhu's explaining Sanatana Goswami and all these things is to elevate impersonalist to the level of personalist understanding. And one strong aspect of impersonalists is that they take shelter of Vedas, some portions of commentaries by certain great scholars, and they philosophically debate how impersonalism is ultimate. If you recollect the story of Govinda Bhashya by Baladeva Vidya Bhushan, when Baladeva Vidya Bhushan had to counteract the Mayavadis, he needed the help of a Bhashya. When Brahmanudacharya has to debate, he needed a Bhashya. In fact, he needed to understand what is written in the Advaita philosophy to even counteract. So, Acharyas one of the main contribution that they have done in their preaching mission was to give us a very deep philosophical depth and treatise, wherein we are not only sentimentally following Krishna consciousness, we also have an opportunity to scientifically understand Krishna consciousness. So these four dimensions are to explain the scientific perspective of Krishna consciousness, which we are all expected to follow as a part of our being independently thoughtful, rather than just be a dry philosophers like that of Mayavadis and impersonalists, rather than being a dry philosophers like that of Nirvisheshis and Sunyavadis, rather than try to give some mundane explanations about bodily conceptions of life. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taken a course where I am trying to explain certain things scientifically, at the same time emphatically establish how Krishna consciousness is an ultimate process, and anybody who's associating themselves with the process of devotional service will eventually and certainly give up their bodily conceptions and eventually make it to the Supreme Lord. So we will discuss these four dimensions in a bit now. What is the first dimension about philosophical clarity? It is extremely important, even in this chapter, that analysis, deep analysis, and the fag end when Mahaprabhu was going to give summary study of the 64 meanings. After finishing his 60 explanations, when Mahaprabhu started to give his conclusions and summary, he used to say that now whilst I'm giving a summary, I'm getting further more reflections, and he used to add four more. So the point is that we need to know that the philosophical clarity is expected out of us. When Krishna was there, there were deviants in the garb of a devotional personality. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there were deviants, there were stories and pastimes. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur and contemporary acharyas were there were deviants in the name of Gaudiya. Even now, there are so many deviants in the current ISKCON context. There are different controversial and deviant ideologies. So, Mahaprabhu's intent, Acharya's intent, Srila Prabhupada's intent is to ensure that we don't become a deviant. So, hence the first dimension to the philosophical understanding, scientific way of understanding Krishna consciousness is to make sure that we are not philosophically, deviant. We are very clear. I'll give an example of philosophical deviation, many, many examples. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing how there is a book written by Suhotra Swami, one of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada. The book name is called Apasampradaya, where Bhaktivinoda Thakur is already warning each and every practitioners of Krishna consciousness to be careful of Apasampradayas. And he's explaining about caste Goswamis. He's explaining about people following in the family lineages of, personalities, and they proclaim that this is the correct understanding, other things are not correct. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, just because somebody is wearing Gaudiya Vaishnava Tilak and having a bead bag and shika does not necessarily mean what he is speaking is always the fact. So we have to be very careful in aligning ourselves to the right Chaitanya tree. We have to align ourselves to the right Chaitanya branch. We have to align ourselves to the right root of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's family, not get carried away to some lookalikes. The so-called Ritvik philosophy, the so-called debate on the Jivatma, whether he fell down to the spiritual world or not, the conversations about whether Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can be given more pankha or not, there's so many such conversations, and so many, some of them are some philosophical research that some devotees are doing. Some of them are clear-cut established deviant ideologies, and some people starting to believe that they are correct, and they are propounding that philosophy and adding more and more people. So, Srila Prabhupada's one of the main agenda is to ensure that we have philosophical clarity. For that, we need to align ourselves very nicely with a bona fide and with genuine honesty for the purpose of ultimate goal. We should be steadfastly connected to the philosophical processes enunciated by Srila Prabhupada. It's very tricky, there's very subtle differences, but still we need to be stay grounded there. So that is why we need to always stick on to Srila Prabhupada's purports. Books are the basis. And we need to develop this sense of service attitude. We'll come to that. There are some more reflections that I want to share. So anyway, the first dimension is philosophical clarity. To help us to get the philosophical clarity, we may be clear, absolutely clear in terms of the basic line of thought, but to make sure that we stay put there, the second dimension is explained, which is scrutinizingly study that philosophy. What is scrutinizingly studying the philosophy mean? Every aspect of Krishna consciousness philosophy, when you dig deep, there are layers of understanding. Like the books called Madhurya Kadambini, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, they are all books for scrutinizingly studying Vedic literature, wherein the author has analytically and very detailedly explained the aspects of devotional service. So, from desire to the destination, at every level, we may theoretically know certain information, but when we study them scrutinizingly, we get to know the depth of them also. Like for example, Shraddha is a very important process. But Shastra talks about different layers of Shraddha, different layers of Sangha, different layers of Seva, different layers of desire. So if you just only scratch the surface, which by now, as students of Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, we all speak Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita lectures, we all do understand certain things. But when you scrutinizingly study, it helps us to become independently thoughtful. That is why Srila Prabhupada kept Bhakti Shastri, Bhakti Vaibhava, Bhakti Sarvabhauma, Bhakti Vedanta. Why he has kept this? Because he expects all of us to very detailedly study this. Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipunau Sadharma Samstapakau. What was Goswami's purpose, job, seva? Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipunau. They scrutinizingly studied the Vedic literature and establish Krishna consciousness. By studying all the Vedic literature, sometimes they studied certain so-called Mayavadic literatures and have to give the counter to them. So they very nicely studied and eventually giving us. That is why we are so blessed by being Rupa Anugas, by being Prabhupada Anugas, by being students of Brahma Bhadra Gaudiya Sampradaya. We are so blessed because we don't need to do all those extra work. What is being given to us by our Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas up to Srila Prabhupada, we have enough things to study, understand, assimilate and progress. What if you have to, you know, study and compare between Rig Veda and, you know, Sama Veda and, you know, start doing that? We won't be able to do that. But somebody has done it. So, the second dimension to the philosophical perspective over here is that whilst philosophical clarity is good, we can get philosophical clarity only when you scrutinizingly study. The third dimension is by studying the Vedas or by studying this literature scrutinizingly. If we do not apply them in our lives, then what's the value of them? As we always speak about applications in Krishna consciousness, so it is extremely important that we need to apply. And Srinivasacharya, when he is glorifying Sadgoswami, he is telling two things. One is he is telling Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipunau, which means they scrutinizingly studied the Vedas. And what did they do? Yatva Turnamatesha Mandalapati Shrenim Sadatuchavad. So they studied the Vedic literature and they started to apply by giving up all the upadhis, giving up all the designations, giving up all the identities and simply focusing on the core aspects of Krishna consciousness. So similarly, we understand the philosophy, we analyze and go depth of the philosophy and scrutinizingly assimilate them, and the real fruit of it is when we apply them in our lives. So application aspect of Krishna consciousness is very important. And the fourth dimension is, by doing so, we will be the recipient of Lord's mercy. So this verse number 224, which is a kind of a summary of 220 to 223, these four dimensions are explained. Number one, by understanding the process, which is the process of devotional service. Number two, meditating upon it, which means scrutinizingly go deeply study. Number three, engaged in the Lord's service. And number four, as Prabhupada writes in the purport, that we will also be eventually, but certainly, understand the mellow of devotional service, which means we will become the recipient of Lord's mercy. The fourth dimension, I just wanted to, you know, talk for 2 minutes on that, where one is we function in such a manner that we are recipient of Lord's mercy, which means the Lord is merciful upon us, Vaishnavas are merciful upon us, our spiritual master is merciful upon us, we bring in a smile in all of their faces. And a fourth dimension can also mean, unless and otherwise, we receive their mercy, unless and otherwise, we receive knowledge with mercy, unless and otherwise, we scrutinizingly study with the mercy, no magic can happen. So this is second set of reflection. The third set of reflection is also where when Mahaprabhu is explaining about this Atma Rama, different meanings of Atma Rama, he is trying to categorically alleviate, completely clear some misconceptions. Krishna is talking to Arjuna in the 5th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, text number 25. Krishna is saying to Arjuna that, my dear Arjuna, until and otherwise, if one is free from the doubts arising out of dualities, unless and otherwise one is self-introspective, I'm paraphrasing, unless and otherwise one is free from sin, And finally, unless and otherwise, one who is working for the welfare of the humanity at large, liberation is not possible. So my third reflection is, by Mahaprabhu scrutinizingly and categorically explaining these things, he is also paving the way for the students of Chaitanya Charitamrita, as well as anyone who is listening to these narrations, so that the doubts arising of duality. What is duality here? When we are self-centered, duality is there. When we are Krishna-centered, there is nothing called as duality. So long as we are bodily conscious, dualities will be there. We like, we dislike. Morning, evening, heat, cold, good, bad. So there is always dualities. Dualities is a sign of self-centeredness. So long as a person is self-centered, dualities cannot go off him. And because of those dualities, so many doubts will come. That is why anyone who is bodily conscious, for him to surrender to the Supreme Lord unconditionally is very difficult. Because of his attached nature to this body, he will be very much conditional. Only so long as I am going to get benefit of this process, I will follow it. Otherwise, I will not follow it. So that's called conditional worship or conditional prayer. But one who is surrendered to Krishna unconditionally, for him there is nothing called as good, bad. That is what Mahaprabhu explained before coming to this side of the explanation. The 13 explanations, one of the explanations of Atmarama, he explained that how a self-realized soul is unaffected by any of the materialistic nature and is fully self-situated in Krishna consciousness. So hence the third reflection is that we need to get independently thoughtful. We need to understand the four dimensions of Krishna consciousness philosophy so that we can get purified, cleared of our doubts, caused out of our dualities, which means we will get to Krishna conscious slowly but certainly. And that will make us to become self-introspective. And that will make us be sinless. And eventually we can work for the welfare of others. So if you want to know more about this, you can read Bhagavad Gita, verse number 5, text, chapter 5, text 25. Of course, the context over there is Krishna consciousness in the practical application. But I just want to connect that into this current context, wherein Mahaprabhu explaining about these four different explanations of Atma Rama is pretty much fitting into that understanding. So the preaching, the book distribution, and all the initiatives that we are trying to do as a part of the soldiers of the Sankirtan movement is a welfare activity. But that activity can happen one and only when we are sinless, free from doubts, as well as regularly self-introspective. In the sense, even if we are in the process of it, not fully accomplished, not fully purified of us, not fully cleansed. So long as we are working in that process, it will help us. And definitely within the same life, we will become liberated. That is what Bhagavatam says. That anyone who is associated with the process, Kirtanat Eva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Param Vrajet. So we will be considered liberated just by being part of the Sankirtan movement. How? Just by the process that I explained. So that's the third reflection. And the last reflection is a simple acronym for application. We use the acronym APPS. APPS means applications. And in our case, APPS meaning attitude first, process follow, practice next, gain self-realization. Attitude, without attitude, we cannot follow a process. When attitude and process are together, we can follow, practice Krishna consciousness. And when with the right set of attitude, with the right process, with the right practice, we will get self-realization. We spoke about it at length last week in Bhagavatam class. So these are the four sets of reflections to this current context, wherein Mahaprabhu is trying to explain how a person laboring in bodily conception of life, when he comes in contact with a pure devotee, he comes in contact with this process of Krishna consciousness, he will be able to move forward in Krishna consciousness. It is very nicely explained that in Kevala Ashtakam, Aho Dukkam Maha Dukkam Dukkha Dukkha Taram Yataha Kachartam Vismritam Ratna Harer Namaiva Kevalam. So long as we have the materialistic consciousness, bodily consciousness, we will consider a jewel as broken glasses and the broken glasses as jewel. Kachartam Vismritam Ratna. That's what Mahaprabhu was explaining, referring to the prayer Guru Maharaj has offered, where he explains that I was searching for broken glasses by explaining how I was interested in worldly affairs, bodily affairs. Now I got your association, I got jewel. And so Mahaprabhu is once again establishing Krishna consciousness perspective for a impersonalist. So to summarize our conversation, we had four sets of reflections from verse number 220 to 224. There are four points that Srila Prabhupada is explaining, on based on which we are explaining these four reflections. The idea was that one of the meanings of Atmarama means one who is laboring in bodily conception. And further he is explaining that where he will definitely in due course of time by certainly giving up bodily consciousness be situated and for that Prabhupada is giving an example of primary purpose as well as secondary purpose and he says the process is sublime that the Atma Ramas are also engaged and will eventually get there. The four reflections are number one devotees are expected to be independently thoughtful and number two four dimensions of philosophical understanding in Krishna consciousness number one being having a philosophical clarity number two being having in-depth scrutinizingly study the Vedic literature number three is about practicing and applying the understandings in our daily lives and fourth being the recipient of the Lord's as well as the spiritual masters and Vaishnava's mercy and as an additional point we mentioned that knowledge received with mercy will melt our anarthas and cleanse it off knowledge received without Vaishnava's mercy will make our heart hard. So mercy component that is explained is one is being the recipient by our action and decision. Second is by seeking the blessings we will be able to apply as well as understand Krishna consciousness perspective. And the third reflection was that to gain there, to get there, we need to get rid of our doubts arising out of duality, which is arising out of our bodily consciousness, identifying ourselves with the body. So we were referring to the fifth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, text number 25, where four things are explained. One is free from the duality doubts, self-introspective, free from sins, and working for the welfare activities will get us liberation. So in our case, in this current context, Mahaprabhu's explanation and direction is also heading us towards that. Then how we can be doubt-free, how we can be not be part of bodily consciousness. And such explanations of Bhagavatam gives us opportunity to be introspective. And for sure, Mahaprabhu has explained about people with sins and abominable thoughts and actions cannot come closer to spirituality. So from that perspective, enough importance has been spoken on the practices and how we need to avoid sinful activities. And finally, working for the welfare of humanity at large, which is our Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. And the fourth reflection was just a recap and rejoinder here about the acronym APS, which means attitude comes first. With the attitude, follow the right set of process. With the right attitude, following the right process, practice them in our daily life for us to get self-realization. So with this, I end here. If there are any questions or comments, we can discuss. Thank you very much.
श्री श्री चैतन्य चरितामृता की जय, श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। एनी क्वेश्चंस और कमेंट्स?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you for the very nice class and summarizing all the realizations that you have. Thank you very much, Prabhu. Anyone has any questions or comments for Prabhuji, please go ahead. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. These chapters are a bit technical and sometimes, spins us to a completely different dimensions altogether. So I'm so sorry, just in case if I went too technical or too dry or too confusing, I can clarify some points. Okay, as expected, definitely this is a bit on the tougher side to even explain, speak. I was actually thinking how I'm going to, speak on this point, but whatever little intelligence, our acharyas bestowed upon me, I did my job, and sorry in case if I was not clear on any of these points. Thank you very much.
Not at all. You were very clear, Prabhu. Not at all. Anyone wants to ask Prabhuji anything? Okay. So thank you again.
Okay.
Thank you so much for coming on the call and giving us your association. So if no one has any questions, comments or realizations, we can end the call. Vansha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyai Vacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavedyo Namo Namaha Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Sri Sri Chaitan Charitamrita Ki Jai His Grace Ram Giridhari Prabhuji Ki Jai. Hare Krishna.
Recorded.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.